Hello and welcome to Jobs and Education. Do subscribe, like and share my videos. This is your Mahesh Dole. This is the third series in the video which is covering workshop technology for ESET exam. So in this video we are covering metal removal processes according to SBTET syllabus. So this is a classification of metal removal processes, like conventional machining is there, abrasive processes are there, non-traditional machining are there. So in conventional machining, turning, drilling, milling, this kind of machining operations are there. In abrasive processes, grinding processes and other abrasive processes are there. And non-traditional machining processes are like mechanical energy processes, electrochemical processes, thermal energy processes, etc. These are the different classification of metal removal processes. These are the important metal removing processes like turning, drilling, milling, grinding, broaching, which you've seen in your diploma. So let's get started with the first question. Which machine tool is known as the mother machine tool? So out of all the machine tools, which is a mother machine tool? So here you can see this figure. This is a lathe machine. So this is called as the mother machine tool. Second question reads, which came in ESET 2020 exam, a twisted drill is specified by its shank and material and what else? So a twisted drill is specified by its shank, material and some other thing is there, like length of its body or diameter, lip angle or size of float. So here you can see shank diameter and all this is about the specifications of a twisted drill. Hence the correct answer is diameter. A twisted drill is specified by its shank, material and diameter. So three things are there. Third question reads, surfaces produced by straight and cylindrical grinding tools tends create which type of roughness? So cylindrical grinding, it creates which type of roughness? So out of given options, C is the correct answer, irregularly spaced but directional roughness. This question was came in ESET 2020. So C is the correct answer. Cylindrical grinding tools creates irregularly spaced but directional roughness. Fourth question reads, lathe bed is usually made up of. So lathe bed is usually made of which of the following given materials? So that is, these are the parts of a lathe machine. The base is at the bottom. Hence the correct answer for the lathe bed material is cast iron. B is the correct answer. Fifth question reads, which type of surface is produced by turning operation in lathe machine? So turning operation in lathe machine produces which type of surface? So by looking at this figure you can understand it is cylindrical surface. Hence the correct answer is B, that is cylindrical surface. Sixth question reads, lathe centers are provided with the following standard taper. So in the figure you can understand what is the type of taper. So that may be metric, British, Morse or any taper. Hence the correct answer is C, that is Morse taper for the lathe centers. Seventh question reads, what is necessary condition for turning? What is the necessary condition for turning operation? So out of given options, here the correct answer is cutting tool should be harder than the material of workpiece. Cutting tool should be harder than material of workpiece. B is the correct answer. These are the cutting tools. Next, eighth question reads, which of the following operation we cannot perform on drilling machine? So drilling machine is used for multiple operations. So out of given operations, which is not belongs to drilling machine? Here these are the drilling machine operations, which you can see trepanning, tapping, lapping, reaming, counter boring, boring, step drilling, etc. So many are there. So here the correct answer is none of the above. Means reaming, tapping and lapping are belongs to drilling only. Ninth question reads, which of the following is not a part of drilling machine? So out of given options, which is not belongs to drilling machine parts? So spindle, head, mandrel, column. So these are the parts of drilling machine. Here mandrel is not there in these parts. Hence the correct answer is C, that is mandrel is not belongs to the drilling machine. Tenth question reads, which of the following drilling machine is suitable for a job with multiple holes? So to get multiple holes, which of the following drilling machine is used? That is, gang drilling machine is used to produce multiple holes. Hence the correct answer is C, that is gang drilling machine. 11th question reads, a cutting tool used to finish and enlarge a hole is known as. Cutting tool used to finish and enlarge a hole is nothing but, by looking at this figure you can understand that is a reamer. D is the correct answer. Reamer is used to finish and enlarge a hole. 12th question reads, a drilled hole goes out of center due to. A drilled hole goes out of center due to, maybe out of this given options the correct answer is any of the above. It may be improper clamping of workpieces, or workpiece having blowholes, a center punch mark not being large enough to give proper seat. So these may be the options. Okay, so any of the above is correct regarding a drilled hole goes out of the center. 13th question reads, cutting T-slots as seen in this figure. So cutting T-slots can be performed more efficiently by which milling machine? So out of given milling machines, which is used to produce T-slots efficiently? So this is vertical milling machine. This is useful for effective T-slots. So B is the correct answer. Vertical milling machine used to produce T-slots effectively. 14th question reads, during milling, the cutter usually moves. During milling, the cutter usually moves, maybe perpendicular to its axis or parallel to its axis, inclined to its axis. Hence, the correct answer is perpendicular to its axis. Cutter is usually moves perpendicular to its axis. A is the correct answer. 15th question reads, the cutting tool in a milling machine is mounted on. The cutting tool in a milling machine is mounted on. So that is mounted on, look at this. It is mounted on arbor. Hence the correct answer is C, that is arbor. Cutting tool is mounted on arbor. 16th question, down milling is also called as. It may be conventional milling or climb milling or end milling or face milling. The correct answer is climb milling. Down milling is also called as climb milling. 17th question reads, Woodruff key milling cutter is a type of. Woodruff key milling cutter is a type of. Maybe plain milling cutters or side milling cutters or end milling cutters or face milling cutters. So that is Woodruff key milling cutter is end milling cutters. C is the correct answer. 18th question reads, grinding wheel is specified as A 46, K 5, B 17. So grain size of a wheel will be, out of these A 46, K 5, B 17, grain size of wheel will be, that may be coarse, medium, fine or very fine. So based on this given A46, K5, B17, this grain size of the wheel may be coarse or medium or fine or very fine. So it depends on this information. So coarse is from 8 to 24, medium is from 30 to 60, and fine is from 70 to 180, and very fine is 220 to 600. This is the grain sizes. So 30 to 60, 46 is in the middle of 30 to 60, that's why it is medium. So A46 means it is, its grain size is medium. B is the correct answer. 19th question reads, grinding is best suited to the machining of. Grinding is best suited to machining of very hard materials. B is the correct answer. Next, 20th question, synthetic oil is used as cutting fluid in grinding for. So synthetic oil is used for cutting fluid in grinding for cast iron, a stainless steel, or plastic, or all of the above. Hence the correct answer is all of the above. To cut for the grinding of cast iron, stainless steel and plastic, the synthetic oil is used as cutting fluid. 21st question, in electrochemical grinding, grinding wheel is, in electrochemical grinding, the grinding wheel is negatively charged. B is the correct answer. 22nd question, in centerless grinding, workpiece is supported by. In centerless grinding, workpiece is supported by maybe centers or chuck or work rest and all of the above. But the centerless grinding workpiece is supported by work rest. C is the correct answer. 23rd question, broaching can be used for. It may be used for threading, grinding, spline cutting or increasing the size of the hole. Hence the correct answer is spline cutting. Broaching can be used for spline cutting. In this figure you can understand that spline shaft. So 24th question, how many types of broaches are there? So 3 or 5 or 8 or 9. Actually, the broaches are 9 types are there. Pull type, push type, ordinary cut, progressive cut, etc. Up to form relief type, 9 types are there. Hence, the correct answer is D, that is 9 types. 25th question, a brooch has roughing teeth or semi finishing teeth or finishing teeth or all of the above. So brooch has all of the above, roughing teeth, semi finishing teeth and finishing teeth. So these all are correct. So this is the ending of the video regarding metal removing processes. So all the best for your coming up ESET exam. This is your Mahesh Dole signing off.